All right, just finally, Rex, should a government bailout be on the cards here?
Look, first of all, I think it's really important to say that there are a lot of people out there hurting today. And we're not talking about, you know, passengers who have been inconvenienced, and certainly that's a big deal. But the employees of Rex really only heard about the fact that their own company is teetering on the edge in the last 48 hours. And there's a lot of families making some, you know, pretty tough decisions themselves right now. On top of that, regional communities rely on Rex. I was up in Alice Springs just a few months ago with the Cost of Living Committee, and we were talking to the Europinga School, who was saying that, you know, they actually rely on the regional airlines and the airport in Alice Springs to provide reasonably priced airfares, because otherwise they can't attract the teachers to work in that school. People simply won't come to remote communities or regional communities if they don't feel like that they have access to big cities at a reasonable price.
So there is a case for a government bailout?
The government has failed here. Well, I think the most important thing here is that the government works closely with the executive of Rex, with the administrators, with the ACCC, with the regulators, to make sure that there is an outcome that works for everybody. Because, you know, what we've seen is Anthony Albanese criticise Rex for making a commercial decision to operate in on routes where Qantas was operating. Now, you know, Fair go. I mean, a company is entitled to make commercial decisions that it thinks is in its interest.
But I mean, as we sit here now, it wasn't in its interest, it turns out.
Yeah, but, you know, this is a government that, you know, that clearly isn't interested in having competition in the airline industry. We saw that in its decision to block Qatar from getting additional access routes to Australia. You know, I think that they're perhaps barracking for one carrier here. But regional communities need Rex. They need Rex. They need to have competition in the airline, in our aviation system. And the government should keep that first and foremost in its mind, because our regional communities will simply die a slow and painful death without accessible airlines and at affordable prices.
But you're not quite willing to leap to the government bailout at this point?
Well, we're only 2 days into this process. Yeah. I would very much hope that Anthony Albanese, rather than admonishing Rex, would actually work with them.
OK, does that mean bailout should be on the cards, though?
Well, I think Jim Chalmers has already said that nothing's off the table. The most important thing, though, is that they work with the administrators, with the executive and with the ACCC to ensure that there is competition in our airline system and that our airlines are viable.
Jane Hume, always good to talk to you. We'll see you soon.
See you, Laura.